A pleasant day, everyone! This is Teacher Marlene to discuss about modeling, representing, and transforming quadratic functions. Let us have a short review of a function. It relates to a machine with input and output. And the output is related to the input, meaning the output is all depends on the input. Now, let us study the quadratic function. It can be written in the form of f of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, or y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. It is a process that associates to a relation of each element of x to a single element on the other set like y. So there is a one-to-one relation between x and y. Let us see how to model a quadratic function. This is a basketball. We have a soccer ball. And we have a softball. Can you imagine how these balls move while we are playing them? In shooting basketball to the ring, or if the player kicks the soccer ball and the player hits the softball, the tendency of the ball moves in a projectile motion. Or the motion of the ball is in a parabolic movement. That curved path was shown by Galileo to be a parabola. Here are the illustrations of the bouncing balls. If we look in our surroundings, there are several structures in the form of parabola. Here are the two famous examples. The signage of the entrance of Santa Rosa. The all-time favorite McDo, where its symbol is an example of figure of parabola. And there are lots of parabolic shapes in our environment. Now, how can you determine a quadratic function? The first one is by equation, or we call this function. Let us take a look at the following examples. 1. If y is equal to 3x squared plus x minus 5. So by looking at the degree, its degree is 2. Therefore, it is a quadratic function. Next, if the function of x is equal to negative 5x plus x squared. Again, its degree is 2. So, it is a quadratic function. Look at x times the quantity of x plus 3 times the quantity of x minus 3. It looks like a linear function. But, if the function is simplified, it would be y is equal to x cubed minus 9x. Since the highest degree is 3, then we can say this is not a quadratic function. Another way to determine a quadratic function is by using table of values. A relation is a quadratic function if equal differences in x produce equal second differences in y. Let us observe the table. The x values ranges from 1 to 5, and y values are 1, 4, 9, 16, and 25. If we're going to get the differences in x, 2 minus 1 equals 1. 3 minus 2 equals 1. 4 minus 3 is also equal to 1. And 5 minus 4 is also equal to 1. Observe that we have equal first differences in x. Now let us look at y values. Getting the differences, we have 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. 16 minus 9 is equal to 7. And 25 minus 16 is equal to 9. So these are the first differences in y. Let us continue getting the next differences. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. And 9 minus 7 is also equal to 2. Observe that 2 is the common as second differences in y. So if we have equal differences in x and equal second differences in y, then we conclude that this is a kind of quadratic function. Now let us look at this table. The value of x are negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, and 1. While y values are negative 5, negative 3, negative 1, 1, and 3. Let us get the differences. Looking at x values, we will get negative 2 minus a negative 3 will give us negative 2 plus 3 is equal to 1. Then negative 1 minus negative 2 will give us negative 1 plus 2, which is also equal to 1. Then 0 minus negative 1 is equal to 0 plus 1 or 1. And of course, 1 minus 0 will give us 1. Again, we have common first difference in x. Now look at y values. 3 minus negative 5 is the same as negative 3 plus 5, which is equal to positive 2. Negative 1 minus negative 3 is the same as negative 1 plus 3, which is also equal to positive 2. Then 1 minus negative 1 is equal to 1 plus 1, or equal 2. And the last one, 3 minus 1, it's also equal to 2. We obtained common first differences in y, but in our rule, it must be on the second y differences. Therefore, this value is not a quadratic function. Another way to determine a quadratic function is by graph. Observe the curve formed in the Cartesian plane. It is a parabola. The parabola opens upward. On other hand, the other graph is inverted parabola. It opens downward. So anytime you draw and arrive at any of this graph, we can say that we have quadratic function. This time, let us show the process of transforming quadratic function from y is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, or the general form, to y is equal to a times the quantity of the square of x minus h plus k, wherein this is also called as the standard form. The standard form is also known as vertex form, because the vertex, which is represented by h and k, is the maximum or the minimum point can easily be pointed out. So to find the vertex of the parabola, we have to follow the following steps. First, we have to group the terms containing x. If a is greater than 1, factor out a. Then we will complete the expression inside the parentheses to make it a perfect square trinomial. Then finally, express the perfect square trinomial as a square of binomial and simplify the other parts. Now, let us apply these steps in the following examples. 1. Transform y is equal to x squared minus 8x plus 2 to vertex form. Applying step 1, we will enclose terms with x. So, y is equal to the quantity of x squared minus 8x plus 2. Since the coefficient of x squared is 1, we're going to skip step 2. Now, let us proceed to step 3. Get 1/2 of the coefficient of x, which is negative 8. So, 1/2 of negative 8 is negative 4. The square of negative 4 is 16. Since they are both in one side of the equation, add and subtract is our process. Since we add negative 4 square inside the parentheses, then we subtract 16 outside the parentheses. Then let us apply step 4. Inside the parentheses, it's now a perfect square. So y is equal to the square of x minus 4. Then combine 2 minus 16 is negative 14. This is the vertex form. So y is equal to the square of x minus 4 minus 14. So our vertex is 4, negative 14. Now let us transform. Y is equal to 3x squared plus 6x plus 10 in standard form. For step 1, y is equal to the quantity of negative 3x squared plus 6x plus 10. Since negative 3 is the value of a, so we have to factor it as indicated in step 2. So y is equal to negative 3 times the quantity of x squared minus 2x plus 10. For step 3, 1/2 of negative 2 is negative 1. The square of negative 1 is 1. But we need to multiply it by the value of a. So we added and subtracted negative 1 squared times negative 3. So that we simplify into step 4, we will get y is equal to negative 3 times the square of x minus 1 plus 13. So the vertex is 1, 13. Well, try to practice and master the steps. And to become a master at any skill, it takes the total effort of your heart, mind, and soul, working together in tandem. God bless everyone!